Congratulations on the purchase of your ATV. All-terrain vehicles are highly versatile machines that have a vast number of uses for work and pleasure in a wide variety of environments. This DVD is to help you when starting out on your new all-terrain vehicle, or ATV. Riding can be great fun, and your ATV can also become a very useful tool. But an ATV is not a toy and should be operated properly. Careful preparation, along with plenty of practice, is the safest way to ensure you and those you're riding with don't come to any harm. Your ATV will handle very differently to a car or motorcycle, so take time to get used to it. There are many different types of ATV, and they all handle differently, depending on their basic design and how they are equipped. Take time to understand how your machine works. Make sure you read and understand your owner's manual and pay special attention to the warning labels on your ATV. There are a few golden rules to always bear in mind. Take an approved ATV rider training course. Details of your nearest training provider can be obtained from your local dealer. Always wear approved head protection, goggles, gloves, and other protective gear. Read and understand your owner's manual and familiarize yourself with all the warning labels displayed on your ATV. ATVs are designed to be used on unpaved surfaces only. You should not ride on any paved public road. Never ride under the influence of alcohol or other drugs. Never carry a passenger unless your machine is specifically designed and equipped by the manufacturer to do so. Only ride an ATV that is specified for your age. And supervise riders younger than 16. ATVs are not toys. Ride only on designated trails at a safe speed, and always make sure that you have the landowner's permission. By learning the correct riding techniques and following these simple rules, you should be able to enjoy your new ATV to the full and take pride in being a safe and responsible rider. The nature of ATV riding demands that you wear the appropriate protective clothing and equipment. You should wear trousers and boots that come above your ankle. Wear a protective jacket and consider your visibility, especially if you're working. Never ride without approved head protection. It's the most important piece of protective equipment and can prevent serious head injury in the event of an accident. Always ensure your helmet is securely fastened. Strong, well-fitting gloves are a must, and goggles or similar eyewear will protect your eyes. Always ensure safety clothing fits well and is securely fastened, particularly important for younger riders. So, just to recap, you must always read your manual before riding your machine, and keep it to refer to whenever you are unsure of anything. Pay special attention to the warning labels on your ATV and be sure to wear the appropriate protective equipment and clothing. Before starting out, you should make pre-ride checks of your machine. Firstly, check your tire pressure. This is vital for the safe operation of your ATV, as having incorrect tire pressures causes improper handling. The tire pressure of all ATVs is very low, so you should always use the low pressure tire gauge supplied with your machine, and the correct pressure will be on the warning label affixed to your machine and in your owner's manual. Check the condition of your tires and that any wheel nuts are tight. Then check your controls and cables, including throttle, all brakes, gear change, and clutch if you have one. Next, you should check your electrics, include the ignition switch, engine stop switch, and your lights. You always need to check your oil and fuel levels before setting off, using your dipstick or sight gauge, as well as checking for any leaks. Check all vents, the air filter, and the fuel supply valve. Lastly, you should make sure that your chain or drive shaft, chassis, and suspension are all in good condition and working order by checking for loose nuts and bolts and lubricating where necessary. Carry out these checks every time you use your machine. Tires and wheels, controls and cables, lights and electrics, oil and fuel, chain, chassis and suspension. Once you've completed your pre-ride checks, make sure you have an adequate toolkit with you in case you encounter any problems while out on your ride. If you're going out on a trail ride, especially in an area you don't know, you should always make sure you have a few basics with you in case of a breakdown or emergency. Always make sure that at least one of your party has a mobile phone. You need to plan where you're going to ride in advance. Tell someone your planned route and then stick to the plans you've made. Plan the ride and ride the plan. You should always get on your ATV from the left-hand side. Check that the parking brake is on, and holding the handlebar, put your left foot on the footrest and step over the machine. It is important that you can identify, understand and operate all the controls on your ATV. Again, you should refer to your manual for specific information about your machine, but you should be able to locate and operate the parking brake, your front brake, rear brake, either foot or hand operated, the fuel tap and choke if you have one, locate the starter, whether it's kick, electric or pull, the throttle, the clutch on a manual ATV and how to change gear and select the range, and lastly, make sure you know the position of the engine stop switch and how to turn off the ignition. You should remove the key and get off the machine in the same way that you got on, to the left. ATV riding is very different to driving a car or riding a motorcycle. Your stability and safety depends on you being able to shift your weight at the right times and in the correct way. The correct straight line riding position will help you to easily operate the controls and react more quickly when you need to shift your body weight. When making gradual turns, you should lean your upper body to the inside of the turn, concentrating your weight on the outer footrest to allow the inner wheel to slip more easily. When making tighter turns, you should shift your weight by coming off the seat, keeping your feet on the footrests. When climbing or descending hills, you should always shift your weight to the uphill side, adjusting the amount depending on the gradient. You should lean forwards or backwards for gradual hills. And when the incline is steeper, place your weight over the handlebars or over the back of the seat by standing on the footrests. Riding properly means moving your body weight around quite extensively, but always remain in good reach of the controls so that you can use them easily. You must practice these maneuvers while stationary so you understand your position limits in order to keep within safe reach of the controls. You should prepare to start your ATV using the same routine every time. Firstly, set the parking brake. Next, turn the fuel and ignition on. Then make sure the ATV is in neutral. Check that the engine stop switch is in run or start. And remember to use your choke if the engine is cold. Close the choke as the engine warms. Remember to use this routine every time you prepare to start your machine. When you understand how your machine works, you can start to master the basic riding techniques. It's best to find a large, flat, open space to practice in, free of any obstacles or hazards. Before moving off, check that you're in the correct riding position. Apply the rear brake and select first gear. Release the parking brake and gently squeeze the throttle. If you have a manual clutch, release it slowly. If the clutch engages too quickly, the machine will lurch forwards. Always release the throttle when changing gear to prevent the front wheels from lifting. Learn to use the sound of your engine to help you change gear smoothly and at the right time. Your stopping technique will depend on your ATV's braking system and the terrain you're riding on. Release the throttle and change down a gear so the engine slows you down. Ensuring that your thumb is clear of the throttle, apply both brakes equally. Remember to pull the clutch in if you're riding a manual machine. When stationary, apply the parking brake. Practice turning at low speeds until you feel more confident about your abilities, your knowledge of your ATV and how it handles. Slow down as you approach the turn by braking and changing down a gear. Move your body weight forward and to the inside of the turn you are making. turn the handlebars while looking in the direction you are heading, keeping your head and eyes level. And lean into the turn, concentrating your weight on the outer footrest to allow the inner wheel to slip more easily. As your confidence increases, you can attempt tighter turns. For these, you need to brake before you start turning and shift your weight more quickly. Remember to always ride within the limits of your ability. Never attempt maneuvers that you don't feel confident with. You must be able to stop your ATV quickly or swerve to avoid unexpected hazards when out riding, so it's a good idea to practice this too. To stop your ATV quickly, keep your head and eyes up, apply the brakes firmly without skidding, and stop in a straight line. To swerve round a hazard, keep your eyes up and shift your weight to the inside of the turn. Never brake when swerving, and keep your feet firmly on the footrests to stop the ATV tipping over. There may be times when obstacles are unavoidable, and you need to go over them rather than around them. If possible, you should approach them at a 90-degree angle and slow down but maintain momentum. Stand on the footrests with your knees and elbows bent. Just before the front wheels reach the obstacle, give a short burst on the throttle. Lean forward and release the throttle as the front wheels clear it. If you think that only one wheel will mount the obstacle, simply use the momentum of your ATV to get over, without using extra throttle. You should never attempt to lift the handlebars. You will doubtless encounter hills wherever you ride, and you should master the technique for safely going up, down, and across them before setting out. Some hills will be too steep for your abilities, and some may be too steep for your ATV. If the hill looks too steep, it probably is and shouldn't be attempted. The key to good hill riding is to always keep your weight uphill. When climbing a hill, select a low gear and position yourself with your weight forwards. In order to make a turn on a hill, you need to shift your body weight to the uphill side. As you descend, keep looking ahead, shift your weight to the rear, and control your speed using the engine and gradual braking. When climbing steeper hills, you should stand on the footrests and lean forwards with your torso over the front wheels. If you're climbing a longer hill, you may need to change down to a lower gear. You can also go across hills, but should not attempt this on rough, loose, or slippery surfaces. Practice by going up the hill, and before reaching the top, turn to the left or right to cross it. Lean your upper body to the uphill side, keeping both feet firmly on the footrests. Avoid accelerating or slowing down quickly, and if you feel your ATV is tipping, turn the front wheels down the hill or stop and dismount. When descending a steeper hill, shift your weight to the rear of the ATV while standing on the footrests, again using gradual braking. You should practice all the maneuvers you've just seen and increase the difficulty and speed as your competence increases. Always ride knowing your abilities and understanding the capabilities of your ATV. If you're using your ATV as a working vehicle, you may need to carry loads on the ATV itself or by attaching a trailer. It's vital that you consult the warning labels on your ATV as they will indicate the correct load weight that can be safely carried. It's important that you load your racks evenly to maintain the appropriate weight and balance, and always ensure your load is properly secured. If you are using a trailer, ensure it is properly attached and loaded safely. You must know the maximum tow weight, the maximum tongue weight, and the maximum combined tongue and rear carrier weight. Only ever carry loads in accordance with the guidelines on your warning labels and in your owner's manual. If you're going to use a trailer, it's best to take an appropriate training course for loading, towing, and reversing. Always pull a trailer at an appropriate speed for the conditions. Remember to calculate the weights and load carefully, ensuring your load is properly secured. When using a trailer, you must know the maximum tow weight, the maximum tongue weight, and the maximum combined tongue and rear carrier weight. And if possible, take an appropriate training course. Some machines are designed to carry two people, with additional footrests, seating, and handholds for the passenger. The safety of the passenger is the responsibility of the operator. Machines with dual riders should never be operated on a gradient of more than 25 degrees, or the gradient stated in the owner's manual, and should never carry more than one passenger. To get the most out of your ATV, you have to know the terrain you're riding on and understand the capabilities of your machine. Different terrains will affect the handling of your ATV and how you ride it. A good ATV rider stays safe by avoiding risky situations, respecting the riding environment, knowing what's ahead, and being prepared to react well in advance. It's important that you understand how to assess and manage risk, as this will greatly increase your enjoyment of riding. To help minimize risk, you and your riding partners should consider the following five steps. Look. Scan and search the environment, keeping your eyes moving, and look a few seconds ahead at all times. Recognize the hazards by considering the surface you're riding on, thinking about other users and wildlife, as well as stationary objects. Evaluate the risks and predict what will happen. Think about the consequences of your chosen route or actions. Consider the riding techniques you will need to use and predict the outcomes of choices that you make. Make a decision about what to do and pick the best path or route for your capabilities and those of your ATV. Take the route with the best visibility and the least obstacles. Always choose to reduce risk rather than increase it. Implement your decision, adjusting your speed, route, and riding technique accordingly. Carefully choose the places that you ride and never attempt to cross terrain that you are unsure of. Your ATV is equipped to cross mud and shallow water, but you should avoid water that is deeper than your footrests or crossing where you might damage stream beds or cause erosion to the riverbank. If you are unsure of the depth of water or strength of the current, take an alternative route. You should always look ahead for and stay away from dangerous slopes, holes, ruts, and obstacles. You may even have to dismount to check the path ahead is safe. You should always ride within your ability limits and consider the capabilities of your ATV. If you feel you and all those in your group are able to proceed, do so with caution. And if necessary, get a more experienced member of the group to check the route first. ATVs are designed to be used off-road and handled very differently on a paved surface. If you can avoid using a paved road, you should always do so. There may be occasions when crossing a road or paved surface is unavoidable. You should come to a complete stop, look carefully for traffic, and allow them to pass before attempting to cross. Always assume that drivers do not see you. You should cross very carefully, as your ATV may be difficult to control and maneuver on tarmac. Cross the road at a 90-degree angle, where there are no obstructions and your visibility is good. While riding on unpaved public streets or roads may be legal in your area, doing so increases the risk of collision with other vehicles. Make sure you know your country's laws and regulations before you ride on unpaved public roads. Remember, use risk management strategy whenever you are out riding. Look around you, scan and search the environment. Recognize potential hazards, evaluate the risks, and predict the outcome of choices you make. Make a decision about what to do and implement your decisions safely by adjusting your riding technique. Responsible riding also means respecting the environment. There are a number of rules you should always follow. Firstly, only ride where you will create the minimum impact. and only where motorized vehicles are allowed. Always respect the environment and the rights of others. If you meet other riders, walkers or horses, stop, turn off your engine and raise your hand to show that you are aware of their presence. Know about rights of way. Comply with any signs you see and leave gates as you find them. Do you have permission to cross the land you're on? If you're not sure, ask.
We're out on a trail ride. Just wondered if it's your right to cross your land.
Yeah.
Consider the future use of the environment and try to leave it better than you found it. If your route takes you across fields that are full of livestock or livestock are on the trail that you wish to follow, slow right down and allow plenty of space so as not to scare them. Always use existing trails rather than taking a new path. And don't take a route that is likely to damage the land. Stay off soft ground that can be easily torn up and avoid running over young trees, shrubs and grasses as they are easily damaged or killed. Realize the rewards of responsible riding. Remember to respect and look after the environment. Always ride with minimum impact. Respect other users. Know about the routes. Consider the future use and allow others to enjoy the environment you are using. And realize the rewards of responsible riding. Hopefully you found this DVD helpful and it has encouraged you to enjoy your new ATV responsibly and safely. Here's a reminder of the golden rules. Take an approved ATV rider training course. Details of your nearest training provider can be obtained from your local dealer. Always wear approved head protection, goggles, gloves, and other protective gear. Read and understand your owner's manual and familiarize yourself with all the warning labels displayed on your ATV. ATVs are designed to be used on unpaved surfaces only. You should not ride on any paved public road. Never ride under the influence of alcohol or other drugs. Never carry a passenger unless your machine is specifically designed and equipped by the manufacturer to do so. Only ride an ATV that is specified for your age and supervise riders younger than 16. ATVs are not toys. Ride only on designated trails at a safe speed and always make sure that you have the landowner's permission. By learning the correct riding techniques and following these simple rules, you should be able to enjoy your new ATV to the full and take pride in being a safe and responsible rider. This training DVD applies only to ATVs sold in Europe and is intended to provide a general overview of the safe operation of ATVs. The DVD is not intended to be a substitute for the owner's manual provided by the manufacturer of your ATV or for any on-product warning information like labels, and in that sense, no rights can be derived from it. Some of the accessories that appear on the ATVs in this DVD may not be available or recommended for your ATV model or type. For these reasons, please carefully read and understand the owner's manual provided with your ATV and all warning information, in particular the on-product warning labels applied to your ATV. If you have any additional questions about the operation of your ATV, please follow the instructions provided in your owner's manual or contact your local dealer.